Welcome to worship, beloved Living Waters community. We gather for worship online once again in the midst of this pandemic, but through this worship, we continue to praise God, to grow in our faith, and to share the connection that we have with one another as best we can. We also have the good news that Pastor Ivy Houston has accepted Living Waters' call to serve as the next pastor at Living Waters, and with her arrival June 15th, a whole new chapter of ministry together will begin. New ideas, new energy, new ministry. And for that, we give thanks to God, and I pray God's blessing on that new beginning for you all. So in my last Sundays together with you, I would like to begin this worship with a call to worship that celebrates the ministry of Living Waters that God has done throughout history and through the congregation of Living Waters. You'll hear echoes from the book of Isaiah and the Psalms and Matthew, a litany of life-giving water. Sing to God a new song. Sing God's praises from the ends of the earth. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the coastlands and their inhabitants. Let the deserts and its cities lift up their voices in praise. As the heart longs for flowing streams, so longs our soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and behold the face of God? God leads us to still waters, and God restores my soul. Thus says God, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When we pass through the waters, God will be with us, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm us. You shall be wise and build your life's house upon the rock, that when the rains fall, when the floods come and the winds blow, our house shall stand. For this Pentecost Sunday, we include a confession for our worship service. We appeal to the Spirit in three different categories and confess our lives in three different categories using the metaphor of how we might feel dead or dry, how we might feel broken, and how we might feel misshapen. I'll pause ever so slightly in between each of those sections to give you some time for personal reflection and confession. Let us pray. Hear us, O Spirit, as we talk with you about our lives and those parts that are like dead wood that need revival, renewal, and recreation. We want to talk about those parts that are dry and do not give life, those parts we do not feed with imagination or time or effort. Kindle a flame, and from this dryness, refresh us and renew. Hear us, O Spirit. Hear us, O Spirit, as we talk with you about our lives and those parts that are broken. We want to talk about the hurts in our relationships, where our selfishness or our insecurity has broken ties with others, those parts that we cannot mend ourselves, that have broken off from the nourishment of you and others. Kindle a flame, and from this brokenness, reconnect us and renew. Hear us, O Spirit. Hear us, O Spirit, as we talk with you about our lives and those parts that are knotted and gnarled, misshapen because of how we have been treated and how we have treated others, those parts that are scarred and mistreated. Kindle a flame, and from this twistedness, heal and renew. Hear us, O Spirit. And hear, my people of God, God's assurance of pardon. The Spirit renews
renews our dry lives with justice. The Spirit renews our overspent living with love. Spirit renews our broken ways with transformation. Spirit renews our separated humanity with healing. Spirit renews our scarred experiences with imagination. Spirit renews us with new life and sends us into the world together as forgiven people of God, powerful people of God. Amen. Usually for this online worship, we like to keep it short and sweet, and maybe it still will be, but I do want to read all four scripture readings for today. We'll start with the psalm and the second reading from 1 Corinthians. It's Pentecost, and we're celebrating the gift of the Spirit in so many ways, including these four ways in scripture. Psalm 104. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Yonder is the sea, great and wide. Creeping things innumerable are there, living things both small and great. There go the ships and Leviathan that you form to sport in it. These all look to you to give them their food in due season. When you give to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, they are dismayed. When you take away their breath, they die and return to the dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in God's works, who looks on the earth and it trembles, who touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have being. May my meditation be pleasing to God, for I rejoice in the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And I want to riff on this psalm a little bit, specifically using that verse 30. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. And shape that into a beautiful prayer for us. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Renew the joy and mission and ministry at Living Waters, O God. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Renew the health of our planet, O God. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Renew the relationships between your people of all colors and ethnic groups, O God. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Renew the peace in Minneapolis and St. Paul, O God. Amen. And for our epistle reading, or what we call the second reading, it comes from the letter to the Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 12. And I include this because it's a beautiful blessing of confidence and hope for the ministry and gifts of all the people here at Living Waters. 1 Corinthians 12. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles, to another, prophecy, to another, the discernment of spirits, to another, various kinds of tongues, to another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God. We hear two readings from our scripture today on the gifting of the Holy Spirit. The first is from the Gospel of John, John chapter 20, and it takes place after that first Easter day. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hand and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When Jesus had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." This is the gospel of our Lord. And the Pentecost story we hear every Pentecost Sunday is from Acts 2. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "People of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel, saying, 'God declares that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit.'" Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Grace and peace to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Pentecost is the third major festival of the church year, as important as Christmas and Easter, really. But if you were to talk to somebody at school or meet somebody in the grocery store and talk about Pentecost, you might get the response, "What's Pentecost?" The biblical story and our church year give us the story in this sequence. On Easter Sunday, the followers of Jesus are surprised into fear and joy by his rising.
Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and in all places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. God, we call on your spirit of unity, giving thanks for different vocations. Activate and utilize the diverse gifts present in your church, that they will reveal your love for all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, we call on your spirit of life present in air, wind, humidity, storms, oxygen, and our atmosphere, breathing energy into all things. Heal with your breath your whole creation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We call on your spirit of healing, Lord. Bless nurses, doctors, midwives, chaplains, counselors, and hospice workers, and all those who care for the people in need. We pray for all who long for comfort, especially Bennett, Ken, Rebecca, Tom, Colleen, Leah, Sue, Linnea, Danielle, Allison, and David. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord of mercy, we call on your spirit of righteousness. Wherever we are a people divided, unite us. Lord, we pray for peace and healing within our community. We ask you to guide our government and community leaders, our faith leaders, law enforcement, first responders, and members of the National Guard. Lord, we pray for justice for George Floyd and his family. But most of all, we pray for unification. We pray for empathy, for peace, and for justice. Let the love of Christ prevail. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
On behalf of the ongoing ministry of the Community of Living Waters, I want to thank you for your ongoing support and your financial giving, whether you are mailing in a check or giving online or using the new app. If you have any questions about that, just call Katie at the office. But it's partly investing in our future together, and especially the future together with Pastor Ivy, who is coming to join you in ministry June 15th. So partly a support, partly a thanksgiving to God, and partly a gift of excitement, I want to thank you. When we are worshiping together and bring our offering up to the altar, we also offer a prayer. So let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and our offerings in feeding the world with your love, through the one who gave himself for us. Amen. And now receive the benediction. May the glory of God fill you with praise, the beauty of Christ strengthen you in service, and the power of the Holy Spirit fill you with peace. And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be my name.
Thy kingdom come.
The kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
Thy will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven.
On earth it will be on heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses.
Give us our trespasses.
As we forgive those who trespass against us.
Forgive us trespass us.
And lead us not into temptation.
Lead us not in a pen place,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom.
For thine is the kingdom.
And the power.
And the power. And the glory.
Forever and
ever.
Amen.
Amen.